Hey guys, so today is day 19, and our first verse is John 8:11. Go now and leave your life of sin. And so for credit for today, that's actually what I want you to comment in the, like this video, and in the comment section, I want you to put either John 8:11, John 8:11, or go now and leave your life of sin. So let's get started. In this week of forgiveness, we've had the courage to recognize that we are sinful. We've dropped our rocks of judgment. We've forgiven ourselves. We've forgiven others. And we've even prayed for our enemies. There's been a real progression this week. And it all leads us to our quote for today. Go now and leave your life of sin. Earlier this week, we heard the story of the adulterous woman who Jesus forgave. After he had forgiven her and set her free, he then pleaded with her to leave her life of sin. God loves you for who you are, but he loves you way too much to let you stay the way you are. I believe that when we encounter God and his grace, we are not to stay the same. The more we are with Jesus, the more we should want to become like him and leave our former lives. There's an amazing story about how God's grace and forgiveness changed an unlikely person, a tax collector named Zacchaeus. To finish our devotion for the day, let's read his story. Okay, so Bible reading is Luke 19:1-10. Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through. A man was there by the name of Zacchaeus. He was chief tax collector and was wealthy. He wanted to see who Jesus was, but because he was short, he could not see over the crowd. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore fig tree to see him, since Jesus was coming that way. When Jesus reached the spot, he looked up and said to him, Zacchaeus, come down immediately. I must stay at your house today. So he came down at once and welcomed him gladly. All the people saw this and began to mutter, he has gone to be the guest of a sinner. But Zacchaeus stood up and said to the Lord, look, Lord, here and now I give half of my possessions to the poor, and if I have cheated anybody out of anything, I will pay back four times the amount. Jesus said to him, today salvation has come to this house, because this man, too, is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save the lost. If you've grown up in church, you've probably heard the song lyric, Zacchaeus was a wee little man, and a wee little man was he. He climbed up the sycamore tree for the Lord he wanted to see. Because Zacchaeus was a wee little man, many of us underestimate his influence and power. Tax collectors were some of the most hated people around because they were crooks and traitors. They were crooks because they made their money by collecting more in taxes than was due and keeping it. Most of them were rich. They were traitors because their country was under foreign occupation and they were working for the occupiers. They were despised and hated by those around them. And we can understand why. Zacchaeus was not just a regular tax collector. He was a chief tax collector. So he had a team of tax collectors, and he took a percentage of all the money they made by cheating others. Zacchaeus was at the top of this large Ponzi scheme. He was the Bernie Madoff of Jesus' day. Over many years, he had bankrupted many people and made many enemies. He was most likely the richest of the rich, and everybody knew him. But for whatever reason, he wanted to see Jesus. And even more importantly, Jesus wanted to meet him. When they met, Jesus immediately befriended him and welcomed him into relationship. What I love about this story is how immediate Zacchaeus's life changes When the grace of Jesus comes into your life, it prompts change. God doesn't want you to wait on the sidelines warming the bench. He wants you in the game. Jesus doesn't force Zacchaeus to change, but immediately he decides he's going to give half of his possessions to the poor and repay anyone he has wronged four times the amount. That's some serious restitution. Here is a man idolizing money and power and taking advantage of his neighbors. But when Jesus calls out to Zacchaeus, his life is changed forever. He didn't do this to be accepted by God. He didn't do it to be loved by God. He did it because he had been accepted and loved and forgiven by God. When a person sincerely moves what's in his head to his heart, it changes him. It's not business as usual. True repentance says, I once beat prisoners, but now I tenderly care for those wounds. True repentance says, I once used to cheat people financially, and now I repay them back with interest. True repentance says, I used to deceive in business, but now I live with integrity. True repentance says, I used to not take my marriage vows seriously, but now it's till death do us part. After God invades your life, I pray you will never be the same. I pray you will not struggle with the sins of your past, and that instead God can use your pain to be your platform. That's why most people who are in recovery ministry today at one point struggled with addiction in the past. Most therapists went through therapy. If you are struggling with a particular sin, God has given you the forgiveness for it and the power to overcome it. My prayer is that you will leave that life of sin and allow God to use you to help someone else. So for today's challenge and reflection, if you are struggling with a particular sin, write it down and how you will overcome it and how you can help others that may be struggling with a similar sin. Give that thought and prayer, you guys. And if you're writing in a journal, if you're writing down what you've been working on in this challenge in a journal, it's a great place to keep it. That way you can return to it and pray and remember that you're working to overcome this so that you can help others too. So that's day 19.